Frankfurt Book Fair, the podcast.
Welcome from the Frankfurt Book Fair. Since this morning, there's a lot going on in the total of 6 halls. Trade visitors are busily informing themselves on trends and innovations of the publishing business before the fair opens to the general public this weekend. Today we would like to take you to TOC, the Tools of Change for Publishing, the most important American conference on innovations of the publishing industry. And we will report on the Rights Directors Meeting, the meeting point for the trade of rights and licenses, discussing the chances of e-publishing on the market.
Frankfurt Book Fair, topic of the day.
3-year-olds take their first photos with the integrated camera on their mobile. 4th graders download music into their iTunes playlist. While twittering, they keep up to date with their favorite star. Today, young and old profit from the books to go. Entire books are being digitalized and uploaded to mobile devices. The consummation of media experiences a change unimaginable a few years ago. This is why publishers need new strategies, especially digital media, are in the central focus. They are supposed to serve as a forum for discussion as well as a marketing instrument, and this not counterproductively, but in favor of the book, states Sarah Lloyd, digital director with Pan Macmillan, the Australian publishing house.
We need to get that everywhere online. We need to make our books searchable, we need to make them discoverable online, and we need to do that for our content and our authors. So what we did to react to that was to create an online version of the book, which we made open access. We made it open access for the duration of the book club discussion, and we allowed people to read it online for free, and we allowed them to snip it, and when they were actually undergoing the discussion, to snip it from the book, to link to the book and so on, to kind of bring the book into the centre of this conversation that was already happening.
A challenge that will be tackled by the publishers worldwide, as long as they focus on the essentials, according to Andrew Savikas, Vice President of O'Reilly Media Incorporated.
You know, publishers have always been in the business of user-generated content. Very few publishers write their own books. They find the good stuff among all the things out there. And now there's more stuff out there than ever. And so the role of a publisher, the role that they've always played in finding the things that are interesting and important and that matter, is more vital than ever. And the ones that understand that that fundamental job does not change, even though some of the delivery mechanisms change, some of the distribution mechanisms change, some of the creativity changes, but the fundamental job of a publisher doesn't. And the ones that understand that and can try to adapt the skills they already have to the new digital landscape will do just fine.
Innovations and trends of the publishing branch, the experts discussed the whole day during the Tools of Change, in short, the TOC conference. And that for the first time here in Frankfurt. Thomas Minkus, the press officer of the Frankfurt Book Fair, is very satisfied with this major American event.
I think for a first time event in Frankfurt, it worked really, really well. We had about 350 people attending TOC yesterday at the Radisson. I spent about an hour there because I was running around all day like crazy. But I talked to maybe 10, 15 people, and they were quite happy with what they saw, with the talks, with the presentations. And I think most important, or a very important element of these type of events, is the networking, because you can get the right contacts who work on similar issues, whether it's from Brazil, from Italy, from Australia, from Germany, of course, from Scandinavia. So that's what makes it really, really worth your while to attend such a seminar.
However, the more the digital landscape is changing, despite the many opportunities for the market, the more one should not underestimate the risks. Authors and publishing houses repeatedly have to deal with piracy. Content is being copied and distributed without authorization. On the book fair, the 23rd International Rights Directors Meeting has demonstrated how to face the challenges of e-publishing and that there is no way around it. One thing is certain, there is no 100% protection against piracy and violation of licenses in the digital world. Let us listen to David Rottai from the publishing house HarperCollins UK.
Cracking DRM is a sport for hackers, and it's unrealistic that book publishers will be able to come up with an unbreakable system. That said, when we at Harper have looked at examples of where our files have gotten out, frequently it's not ebook files where the DRM has been cracked. It's a PDF on the way to the printer, or someone who's forwarded a Word document along. And there are some specific things like teaching your editors, your authors, your printers, your book reviewers, watermarking your files so that early on in the process you're protecting them and not letting them out of the bag.
The potential of the digital market is enormous. Likewise are the problems of the worldwide violation of rights and licenses. Even Schmidtman, Vice President of Global Business Development at Oxford University Press, New York, states,
people think that piracy might be an issue. Well, piracy is an issue now. Piracy is an issue with print and digital. There are digital forms of books in pirated form that are not available, in print. So you have all kinds of different risks that every industry copes with as they bring out new technology. But I think the potential is truly limitless.
How technology deals with this great potential, we will show you tomorrow with our next edition of our podcast right from the Frankfurt Book Fair. Then we will focus on the creative industries and take a look on how integration of old media into new media works and how tiny digital books of the future look like. The key word for tomorrow is e-reader.